E ngā mata waka o te ao, nau mai, haere mai. Haere mai i ruga te karanga o te whare wānanga o Tāmaki Makaurau. Ke haere mai koutou ki tēnei rā whakahirehira mō tātou te ao. Nō reira, ko horehia te whāriki, ki te ihi, ki te wehi, ki te mana, i ringa i te marae o te rā. Nō reira, e te katoa, piki mai, kake mai, haere mai rā.
Please be seated. Enga mana, enga reo, enga hau e whā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of University Council members and staff of the University. I extend a special welcome to our guest speaker, Dr. Ginny Tipa Daniel, today. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland for the purpose of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. This week, we will be conferring and awarding 6,673 qualifications on some 6,559 students in person and in absentia. At this ceremony, 540 students will graduate in person and 154 students will graduate in absentia. Graduation is a time for celebrating our success. Today, you'll experience the pomp and tradition and recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Each year, we award degrees and diplomas to some 10,000 graduands from all walks of life. Last year, for example, our spring graduands were unique in being capped in the same month as His Excellency Ban Ki-moon, Secretary General of the United Nations, on whom we bestowed an honorary Doctorate of Laws. Mr. Ban encouraged us to think like global citizens and reminded us that the imagination of young people is the most powerful force in the world. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that, compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Put another way, your university experience and the qualifications gained at university will add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. Many of you will graduate today with the first qualification of which you should be proud. However, I also want you to think about the opportunities for research and ongoing learning at the University of Auckland. Our academic staff and postgraduate students regularly make contributions to research, discovery, and learning across a wide range of disciplines. Our research company, Auckland Uni Services Limited, the largest contract research enterprise in Australasia, has over the last decade filed more than 860 patents based on University of Auckland intellectual property, and so has contributed to the growth of new and existing businesses in New Zealand. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In my annual report for 2014, I listed the top academic awards we won last year. I believe we were unique in New Zealand in receiving such a wide range of recognition and awards for teaching, research, and communications across a range of disciplines, including science, engineering, medicine, and the arts. It is without doubt an impressive list of achievements. I invite you to read the annual report and witness for yourself the success that makes us the leading university in New Zealand. I like to think of our university as an innovation engine. The more we conduct world-leading research, the more we recognise for success. The more we win recognition for success, the more research leaders we attract, and the more groundbreaking research we undertake and publish. Through this virtuous circle of reputation, our reputation and ranking is enhanced, and we continue to grow. In time, this will become what self-perpetuating. It will become part of our culture. It will have a huge impact on our economy and our society through the achievement of our students, graduates, and researchers. You can be part of this. Our collective challenge is to do more, even more to serve New Zealand and the world. To me, the way forward is clear. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing, as illustrated by the achievements listed above, and by our having successfully completed last year a major project to enhance specialisation and career opportunities among our professional staff. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. 2014 was notable for our progress on construction of the engineering research facility at our Newmarket campus and a good start on construction of the new science tower on the city campus. In April, Council approved a major demolition and refurbishment of the engineering undergraduate buildings on Simon Street. Together, these three projects represent an investment of over $580 million in high-quality facilities for our outstanding staff and students. So as you graduate today, please consider my earlier suggestion that you reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world. To illustrate to you how important this is, I was reading a Microsoft report recently where one of their development staff was reported as saying, around half of today's occupations won't continue to exist in the future as the pace of change accelerates. So my message to you is to be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. Funding constraints are a perennial problem for New Zealand universities, who are being asked to do more and more with less and less each year. In fact, we should be spending more on universities to strengthen our national economy, not less. But that is enough of the substantial issues facing us all as members of a 21st century university with high aspirations. Because today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I'm pleased to extend a warm welcome to our second speaker this morning, Dr. Jenny Tipa Daniel, who is a distinguished alumna of our university and an internationally accomplished public theologian and professional consultant in higher education. Of Te Rarawa descent, Jenny is a proud and pioneering Indigenous woman who has achieved many firsts in her life. Among these, she was the first Māori in the world to gain an academic degree in theology, and the first Indigenous Anglican laywoman ever appointed to lead an Anglican theological college in the worldwide Anglican Communion. She was globally recognised as Alumna of the Year by her PhD alma mater, Berkeley, California, in 2010. The same year, she became a distinguished alumna of our university, and she holds 4 honorary doctorate degrees for her contributions towards peace and justice through theological education. Jenny served as Aharangi, or Dean, of Te Rauka Hekatea at St. John's Theological College in Auckland for 22 years, during which time she led the International Anglican Peace and Justice Network, heading delegations into parts of the world such as Palestine, Israel, Sri Lanka, Rwanda, Burundi, and the Congo. She has an unceasing commitment to advancing women's leadership generally and is globally acknowledged for her work in mentoring young women from the Third World and Indigenous communities. She is sought after as a guest speaker, lecturer, facilitator, media commentator, preacher, and panelist around the world. We are fortunate to have you with us today. Welcome, Jenny. I have great pleasure in inviting you to address us.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of Council, university graduands, families and friends. I tēnei rā, rangatira koutou katoa. Ko tēnei tō koutou rā whakahirahira, tō rā nunui, nō reire e te whānau whānui, ngā mihi, ngā mihi, tēnā rā tātou katoa. Doesn't this age-old and yet still very splendid ritual make all of those agonised hours of study and meeting assignment deadlines so worthwhile? And for those of you who have supported children, mokopuna, spouses, friends, maybe even a grandparent about to graduate, I hope this very special moment provides you a well-deserved affirmation of all you have done by offering up unconditional support, sacrifice, solace, security, and maybe even just a little exasperation. To my academic colleagues, our shared pride in these ceremonies is just so compelling, and deservedly so. For ours are both the privileged task and the challenge of forming and of shaping, of critiquing and affirming the infinitely precious life of the mind. I know firsthand just how much of your professional commitment is above and beyond, and so it is with humility and admiration that I bow to you for your dedication and so much more. To all the graduands, I offer in advance my own very warm congratulations. As you doubtless nervously anticipate your own unforgettable walk across this stage to receive your tohu, the enduring symbol or official marker of your academic success. To Māori, the word tohu is derivative of the word tohunga. This is the word used to describe those select few set aside for their very specialised expertise, whether as healers, visionaries, wise leaders and inspired teachers, or as guardians of the spiritual realm. Tohunga know they are commissioned or blessed into the service of the people because of their particular gifts, their charism for leadership, and their humility. They are trusted, respected, sometimes even revered, and they act accordingly always with integrity and with considered wisdom. They are fearless and therefore unafraid of speaking truth to power. They exist to serve and thus to sustain the common good. Now I know you are sitting there thinking, well, that's a very lovely story, but what is it actually to do with me? I want to tell you that relatively speaking, it actually has everything to do with you. For irrespective of the nature of the tohu you are about to receive, you too are now being commissioned into the service of others. Because of the particular intellectual gifts and expertise you now have now provably demonstrated, and because of the particular charism and demeanour of the educated person which you now possess, this university, in this fabulous public ceremony, now proudly confers upon you membership of the educated class in our society. Whether you are set to be a high-level specialist tohunga or simply a hard-working, creditable professional, your graduation today, therefore, accords you both a reputation and a responsibility. A reputation that you can be trusted to think clearly, correctly, and critically, and a responsibility to act always with fairness, with dignity, and with decency. You have become what John Henry Newman describes as the ideal graduate. You are now people with clear, conscious views of your own opinions and judgments. You have an eloquence in expressing them and a force in urging them. You have been taught to disentangle a skein of thought, to detect what is sophistical and to discard what is irrelevant. You are now, therefore, each in your own right, well on your way to becoming feisty and confident public intellectuals. And in this moment, I am so honoured to salute you for your academic success and to welcome you with open arms to the shared tasks ahead. You will know that from the earliest times, it has always been graduates who are those deemed worthy of being the rulers or the leaders, those responsible for guiding and influencing the public square with creative and compassionate ideas, with courageous and concise analysis, with bold and innovative new imaginings. In Socratic terms, you are now among those who, once they see the good itself, must be compelled, each in their own turn, to use it as a pattern for ordering the city, private individuals and themselves for the rest of their lives. They will serve the state because they are indebted for their own enlightenment and accept that the good of the city is more important than their own happiness. Philosophical grandeur and elitism aside, in so many ways, those of you graduating today have already indicated a clear apprehension of both the burden and the beauty inherent in your particular sphere of intellectual endeavour. Down through the ages, those involved in the arts and social work and in education itself are traditionally also those seeking to use their knowledge for the betterment of the society in which they live in one way or another. Your decision to choose such a noble pathway in these globally tumultuous times is indeed commendable. Certainly, as I attempt to place myself in your shoes, I am filled foremost with anxiety. For as I said to a graduating class in Berkeley, California, just a few months ago, the 21st century has not gifted us a brave new world, but rather an increasingly cowardly old world, where greed trumps egalitarianism, where charity is contingent upon its tax advantages, where violence, public and private, is endemic, where morality, let alone human decency, appears now as untranslatable into the discourses of the public square, where the milk of human kindness is daily soured by the unbidden human additives of prejudice and bigotry, of race and religious hatred. And yet, it wasn't meant to be this way. 15 years ago, this 21st century began. Our collective hopes soared with particular pride as we bore witness to a globally unprecedented gathering of 189 of the world's political and faith leaders at the United Nations. Gathering across all the humanly created barriers of difference, politics, ethnicity, gender, and economics, these leaders undertook to envision a boldly egalitarian new millennium. The resultant decree, known as the Millennium Development Goals, offered up the most extraordinarily ambitious set of targets. Among them, universal primary education, disease and poverty eradication, environmental sustainability, gender equality, and all of these desperately urgent indicators of human well-being were intended to be significantly achieved by 2015. And that would be this year. Sadly, depending upon which of the officially reported measures of progress you wish to consult, even a cursory read of the ongoing struggles of too many of the poorest of the world remains profoundly discomforting. And in case you hadn't already noticed, our own Aotearoa New Zealand backyard is now hardly pristine either. And certainly, it wasn't meant to be this way. You see, while we boast a proud tradition of universal primary education, the quality of that educational experience for up to 250,000 Aotearoa New Zealand children is daily severely curtailed by poverty and its attendant evils of poor health and domestic violence. Environmental sustainability is constantly threatened, as much by public policy as by public negligence, and the issue of gender equality was just last week framed within such an astonishingly puerile political response that it left most of us aging feminists just shaking our heads with incredulity. This, then, is the context, globally and nationally, within which you as graduates, confident, courageous and compassionate, are now set to make your mark, to offer your contribution. Let me reiterate that I have every confidence in you to reframe the mantra from the passive, "it wasn't meant to be this way," to the proactive, "it does not have to be this way." For yours is the generation which, for the first time in human history, possesses the information, the knowledge, the technology, and the resources to bring the worst of human suffering and injustice virtually to an end. Yours is the generation which must, however, also understand that the promises of the future cannot be fulfilled simply by the acquisition of more and more knowledge alone, but that what is also desperately needed is a commensurate increase in loving wisdom and of reverence for life, for the earth, and for one another. It is in this way that I humbly encourage you to see yourselves, therefore, not just as purveyors of valuable knowledge, but concurrently as exemplars of the civic-minded virtues of compassion, kindness, respect, and generosity. For it is surely only the combination of these treasured human qualities, together with a strong and confident intellectual capacity, which can form model citizens for that most highly prized ideal of a nurturing and free society. A society within which all are enabled to participate, to contribute, and to flourish, and within which none are ever enabled to unjustly dominate or oppress. Let me urge upon you just two cautions. Globalization has always been relentless in its press toward fulfilling its own ends, and I think perhaps the greatest danger we currently face is our inability to apprehend the full extent of the danger which our largely uncritical acceptance of information technology now poses, especially as it brings once distant cultural assumptions, ideologies, and determinations into much closer proximity. Who, for example, would in their wildest imaginings foresee young New Zealanders as radicalized acolytes of jihadi militants? Paradoxically, it is information technology which has also established the most disturbing levels of real-time physical distance between and among human beings. It is for this reason, among others, that I find the term social media curious and entirely misleading. That is because largely what it refers to isn't social at all. Rather, it is solitary and thus largely antisocial. It lacks a credible ethical framework, and it is impossible to secure any reasonable level of moral accountability. In my own sphere of academic discourse, identity politics and tribalism, one of its most perverse manifestations, also remain deeply troublesome post-colonial phenomena. And with respect, I suggest that unless and until our deepest apprehensions of what it means to be truly members of a common humanity are unearthed and enlivened, then any vision of what the common good could yet be will remain just that, merely a vision. We can and we must and we will do better. We can, with the gift, with our gift of abundant intelligence, with our capacity for incisive and penetrating analysis, and with compassion always for those without. We must, because we are looked to similarly as with tohunga, as to selflessly, confidently, and courageously serve and sustain the common good. And so we will, won't we? Whether we act in small, probably publicly unnoticed ways, or whether we are destined to act in profoundly significant, publicly recognized ways, what matters ultimately is that above all else, we do act. For all of this is the mandate, this tohu you are about to receive requires of you to fulfill. Now I know the matters I have raised may possibly be seen as too daunting, maybe even inappropriate for this moment, but right now, as one of you, as one with you, as your immensely proud sister graduate and distinguished alum of this, our esteemed University of Auckland, I feel I would be utterly remiss if I didn't challenge you to consider your ongoing responsibility to both imagine and to innovate the most radical of future possibilities for yourselves, and particularly for those whose futures lie quite literally in your hands. 11 of those of whom I speak are my beloved mokopuna. 11 beautiful, innocent, mischievous, intelligent, precious young people who, along with all the children of this nation and of the world, simply yearn for and so deserve the world of opportunity. On their behalf, then, I ask you to consider whether or not you feel ready to hold their future in your hands. Are you ready to lead with fearlessness and be unafraid of speaking truth to power? Does integrity and wisdom resonate with you? You see, I believe that the least among us, especially the children, surely deserve honest answers to these questions. Let me remind you that I have already expressed my vote of confidence in you, but just in case any of you are still wondering, I have a very simple suggestion to make. And it is that you undertake on this, your graduation day, 4th of May 2015, to hold up a metaphoric mirror, for I guarantee you will catch a glimpse of the tohunga within. Remember, you can, you must, and you will. Of that, I have no doubt. Let me say again, congratulations to you all. Thank you for your forbearance. I wish you all every possible blessing of happiness and fulfillment, as now you turn so deservedly to more formally participate in this your very special day of graduation. Nō reira te whānau whānui, kia maia, kia manawa nui, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa.
Thank you, Jenny, for a most interesting and insightful speech and for the wisdom and guidance you've shared with us all today. Could you please join with me in thanking Jenny once again? This is a meeting of council in convocation of the university at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Arts have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Arts, Professor Greenberg, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honor of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Arts. Diploma in Languages. Matthew Michael Carney. Okay, to the degree of Bachelor of Arts. Muyenye Ma. Sandy Danny McQuan. Nicholas Mannering. Ruben Joshua Lucas Manamanatua Makani. Tessa Justine Maker. Louise Christina Maligan. Alicia Eve Mark. Matthew Lynn Markby. Gorian Markovsky. Stephanie Francis Ann Mondangas Marzen. Adele Joan Masters. Catherine Iris Mathis. Lauren Sarah Mathis. Helen Irene Terito Nakura Otanaroa Matunga. Rory Donald May. Matthew Logan McLennan. Rory Fulton McDowell. Andrew Scott Gillard McEwen. Christy Nolene McFadgen. Kate Erin McGaw. Oliver Andrew Beard McGlone. Sarah Ann McLean. Kirsty McPherson. Carl Brewster McWilliams. Haley Elizabeth Means. Jack Robert Medlin Slater. Caitlin Mary Louisa Melwish. Anthony Ashley Metcalf. Wendy Amelia Middlemas. Matthew Gerard Miles Watson. Christian Milicevic. Lily Miura. Ashley Kate Merman. Nicholas John Mole. Aaron James Monast. Tenley Christina Monroy Bowden. Karima Murad. Ellen Rose Moorhead. Senior Scholar Arts, Tessa Lorna Morgan. Belinda Marie Morris. Taylor Marie Morris. Ottilie Gwendolyn Louise Morrison. Titi Viliamu Motusanga. Junior Mungbun. Martina Muchkova. Rianne Alice Muir. Therese Roisin Murdoch. Alicia Murray. Alamoni Grace Nafe. Sunjali Nagpal. Raina Jyotika Naidu. Yeah. John Edward Nash. Camille Nathan. Sarah Neal. Bethan Ann Needs. Jessica Offey Newberry. Cecilia Mary Nata. Nathan James Natai. Ashley Julia Nicholas. Kendra Marie Nielsen. Shannon Margaret Norgrove. Michael Martin Nutt. Mallory Heather Rose O'Brien. Josephie Rosa Olson. Beth Jean Hawkins O'Reilly. Tess Ann Hawkins O'Reilly. Eden Lillian Antonia Ott. Samuel Ronald Otter, and a graduate diploma in arts. George Rex Otto. Margaret Jane Palmer. Tessa Broadbent Palmer. Denise Carmela de los Santos Palomares. Hayen Park. Jongchan Park. Sangwook Park. Jeffrey Sinclair Parks. Ashik Dharmendra Patel. Chris Earl Payne. Billy Carmel Peterson. Rosalie Louisa Peterson. Chantelle Cherie Perrow. Queenie Peitali Laupepa. Hannah Nimka Petters. Natasha Miriam Ponaya. Daniel Martin Poole. Jamie Karen Alexandra Poole. Kimberly Lara Potten. Sophie Rosa Presland. Amelia Marie Priestley. Emma Linden Proudly. Tema Shendran Teopua. Rebecca Mariah Purvis. Pro-Chancellor, I now call upon Senior Lecturer in Asian Studies, Dr. Chung, to present further graduates.
to the degree of Bachelor of Arts. Robin Kwan. Eleanor Rose Quirk. Georgia Margaret Quirk Looping. Yusra Ragwit. Annabelle Elaine Reddy. Manon Catherine Revuelta. Nathan Robert Rieu. Katie Helena Margaret Rickson. Emily Rose Ridgway. Shahira Rosa Ridwan. Shelley Ann Robertson. Senior Scholar Arts, Thomas Duncan Robertson. Larissa Marie Robison. Marjorie Robin. Charlotte Fleur Robinson. Carly Jean Robinson. Winter Faye Rowlands. Isabel Fane Rogers. Britta Dagmar Shirley Rawlinson. Mahalia Michelle Ralston. Ying Rong. Leonie Rose Ropiha. Nicola Jane Russell. Laurie Leon Ruttersmith. Sarah Jasmine Rikers. Imogen Amabel Jane Sadler, and a graduate diploma in teaching secondary. Anya Domina Maria Samarasinghe. Abigail Samuel. Caitlin Lara Schaufelberger. Benjamin Henry Schlatt. Mihir Sengupta. Liana Grace Teafina Senior. Eun Young So. Anna Maria Francesca Navarro Serrano. Thomas Jeremy Shaw. Alyssa Romanovna Shibalova. Sarika Rehana Shirley. Jessica Louise Silby. Natasha Bekita Silva. Katrina Josette Simpson. Alexander Kenneth Sinclair. Suvishka Singh. Michelle Siu. Alexandra Margaret Tobin Slaybos. Daniel George Smith. Felicity Lana Smith. Lydia Jane Smith. Madeline Jean Smith. Yana Ihepera Smythe. Yi Song. Evie Southwell. Cameron James Staveley. Luke Francis Steiner. Mariana Stetsif. Charlotte Mary Stevens. Karen Joy Stevens. Abigail Elizabeth Strang. Elana Alexandra Stroud. Vitaly Viturovich Sudoplatov. Millie Mingleeson. Laura Marie Switzer. Fa'afete Taito. Matafanua Tamatoa. Karis Winghei Tang and a diploma in languages. Tabitha B. Ting Tang. Laura Ashley Taylor. Luke Carson Taylor. Danielle Diane Tiao. Freya Elizabeth Turney. Shannon Marie Takaronga. Josephine Rosa Titapu Thomas. Lewis Daniel Thompson. Adam Charles Thorogood. David Allen Junrong Ting. Ilana Rachel Tkach. Natalie Letulangi Toevai. Isabel Tone. Alexandra Kate Truscott. Victoria Ilinganoa Tuala. Jamaliet Suilolo Tuiletufunga. Maxine Solinu'u Tukia. Teresa Dupo Fiana Sholi Wayata Duli. Jacob William Twidle. Melissa Jane Underwood. Saini Kaunanga Vaitangitao. Gerson Jesus Valuenza Cisternas. Tessa Jane Van Zolen. Courtney Ann Varco. Viliami Longinusivea. Jacques Leon Venter. Louis Duncan Robert Vetter. Kate Margaret Villers. Lara Delia Waghorn. James William Wallen. Samuel Mark Walls. Emma May Walsh. Han Yi Wang. Wang Yijun. Yin Zhou Wang. Delaney Macareta Malatasi Sarah Watani Tai. Corin Angel Watson. Melissa Ann Watts. Ashley Raina Marie Webster. Kimmy Rose Webster. Imogen Lucy Weir. Xuan Wen. Courtney Joan Wentz. Sayun Annabelle Won. Abigail Grace Wheaton. Maria Adriana Wheeler. John James Wibley. Evelyn May Weil. Holly Ray White. Emily Louise Whitehead. Emma Delmay Lorraine Whitaker. Michael John Whitaker. Alicia Forrest Wichman. Paige Helen Wilburn. Alice Grace Mahoney Wilkins. Deborah Ruth Williams. Eleanor Catherine Rose Williams. Gabriella Maria Williams. Frances Jane Wilson. Senior Scholar Arts, Prudence Sophie Marie Wilson. Stephanie Chloe Winchester O'Sullivan. Chanel Ann Wishart. Hannah Freya Wolfries. Eden Oliver Wong. Wong Gajun. Su Chen Wong. Emma Grace Ray. Zheng Wu. Yuan Zhen Wu. Harrison James B. Nguyen. Nuo Xu. Ye Bin Yang. Scott Yap. Sora Yo. Rachel Jane Young. Rose Ann Yummel. Kevin Jung. Zihao Zhao. Dominique Tepua Zong. Diploma in Languages, Jasmine Chai Suan Po. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts with Distinction, Cassandra Claire Dickinson in Development Studies. Gay Marie Manalo Francisco in Media, Film and Television. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts with Merit, Andrea Lorraine Dorber in Art History and a Bachelor of Arts. Claire Grace Farelli in Psychology. Yue Liu in Development Studies. Postgraduate Diploma in Arts, Akata Alaelua in Criminology and a Bachelor of Arts. Marissa Antoinette Bennett in Criminology. Safira Hardani in Development Studies. Deborah Ann Siata Mann in History. Adam Charles Brooke Parmenter in Media, Film and Television and a Bachelor of Arts. Fangalua Smith in Geography. Celia Elizabeth Wilson in Geography. Postgraduate Diploma in Language Teaching with Merit, Lu Ming Lin. Ying Fei Xue. Postgraduate Diploma in Language Teaching, Jin Min Li. Piao Li. Ying Liu. Eunice Althea McIver. Yi Yang. To the degree of Master of Creative Writing with First Class Honours. Hannah Ramai Nissen Ellison and a Bachelor of Arts Honours with First Class Honours is History and a Bachelor of Arts. Ella Jane Elizabeth Selwyn. to the degree of Master of Creative Writing with Second Class Honours, First Division, Mike Ivor Galvin. To the degree of Master of Public Policy with First Class Honours, Lauren Ann Gent. To the degree of Master of Public Policy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Leah Estelle Beaumont. To the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages with First Class Honours, Karen Frances Hollis. José Antonio Porra Simbaquepa. To the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages with Second Class Honours, First Division, Sean Eris Redwood. To the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Ji Yong Kwon. Hua Zhan. To the degree of Master of Teaching English to Speakers of Other Languages, Evie Joy Aitchison. Hannah Chen. And in absentia, those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma from the Faculty of Arts.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Bernice Austin, accompanied by Wan Kim, will now perform Lucky Child from At the Statue of Venus by Jake Heggie. Thank you, Bernice and Juan, for that delightful piece. Would you please join with me in thanking them once again? By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Education and Social Work, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Education and Social Work, Professor Aitken, to present graduands in that faculty.
Chancellor, as Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Education and Social Work. Graduate Diploma in Teaching Secondary, Lucy Arabella Romaine Anderson. Amy Maria Barron. Anissa Marie Barraclough. Stephanie Claire Bean. Sally Ann Berridge. Eileen Ann Bonney. Gabriel John Boyd. Jordan Winston Bradley. Georgia May Brockhurst. Megan Lee Breyer. Ingrid Edith Buchanan. Karen Jane Chitty. Paulus Hijin Choi. Whitney Jean Cochran. Chelsea Wyatta Marie Collard. Natasha Sophie Helen Marie Collins. Rachel Olive Grace Colquhoun. Aoife Rose Connolly. Amy Bianca Crosby. Sarah Jane Curry. Ben Patrick Curtis. Chad Paul Carpenter Davis. Tanya Pauline Dawson. Alicia Dennison. Priscilla Neha Dinikar. Sally Ann Edgel. Shadell Joy Acton Fial. Elapeta Lolama Fafita. Karen Aidan Ledger Finity. Michelle Christine Foley. Crystal Candace Franz. Alice Mary Gallagher. Rongbang Gong. Craig Allen Grant. Morgan May Gray. Rachel Ann Hamilton. Vicky Philippa Harris. Kylie Marilyn Helston. Cameron Francis Huberts. Jennifer Hutch. Rebecca Elizabeth Hudson. Malia Ann Ikinasio. Lubna Iqbal. Michelle C. Jax. Daisy Louisa Jackson. Helen Elisa Jaffa. Elise James. Sayan Francis Jayathalurka. Rowan Aubrey Johansson. Isabel Francis Wilson Kemba. Meryl Mahilda Cronenberg. Nigel Ng Tat Lim. Shivnita Shamal Lingam. Shalane Margaret Lomas. Erin Jean Lowry. Roni Mafuau. Candice Mary June Marsh. Chloe Elise Marsh. Simon Robert McGinley. Christine Alice Middendorf Carter. Gina Nicole Minahan. Basha Ursula Mystery. Deborah Isabella Mount. Bohenia Falamasami Melu. Elisa Joan Mulcahy. Lauren Charlotte Muldrew. Cecilia Nayata. Shivanjali Satili Nandani. Mitchell Tefera Ngangeko. Jessica Ann Noble. Luke John Oliver. Karen Ruth Olson. Jessica Kate Palmer. Tonita Sala Powell. Timukisa Chantel Pasese. Samuel John Peters. Catherine Jean Louise Filson. Lyle William Crouch. Raneel Rama. Roslyn Roshni Rao. Rangi Nui Uitonga Ricky Rangi Thomas. Yu Yao Rosetto. Sarah Ann Rogers. Renita Danette Roy. Swahela Rizwana B. Shahib. Alistair John Salaval. Stella Seol. Pranita Prasad Sharma. Enna Regina Siono. Alana Judith Smythe. Meloton Soriano. Sarah Ann Standring. Anna Stankovic. Amy Carolyn Stevens. Sarah Ellen Taylor. Dylan Jean Thompson. Janai Louise Thompson. Sean Kui Tong Siong. Ashley Jenna Twist. Alomolotu Ufi. Anna Louise Leia Upton. Tineke Louise Van Houten. Nicola Marie Weston. Sarah Bridget Whitehead. Lauren Joan Whittam. Andrew Jerry Wilson. Harriet Rachel Alexander Wilson. Jordan Brian Wilson. Tanya Kirsten Jane Wilson. Leah Jane Withers. Ashley Nicole Young. Rebecca Sarah Young. Riam Zaya. Graduate Diploma in Teaching English in Schools to Speakers of Other Languages. Teresa Marie Mararahatia Afuk. Amir Ali. Deepa Chaturvedi. Alexandra Cornia. Raymond Edward Kelly. Kyungduk Kyla Lee. Michelle Evelyn Lennon. Ingrid Celeste McKenzie. Hayley Ann Mudford. Lillian Nanai. Zaidar Peterson. Veronica Godsell Ramakers. Lynn Heather Rode. Gillian Ann Shears. Radhika Singh. To the degree of Bachelor of Education teaching English to speakers of other languages. Iqmal Nurhakim bin Mohammed Padil. Siti Nasiha Nasiruddin. Yasmin Binti Safruddin. Nofaza Yoto Azilia Binti Zainuddin. To the degree of Bachelor of Human Services, Stephanie Rachel Beattie. Joanna Rachel Brown. Rosemary Amy Cook. Hamish James Cosford. Kerry Christine Cross. Natalie Leela Ilya. Teresi Evila. Emarina Fennau. Joanna Ruth Fullerton. Mariko Iwasaki May. Kellyanne Cheryl Joseph. Matthew Alexander Saunders. Albert William Scott. Elizabeth Seal. Matalita Liliuokalani Tofa. Michael Samuel Sumio Tawala. Jeremiah Otto Tamanu. Katie Louise Williams. To the degree of Bachelor of Physical Education, Joseph Owen Crooks. Sione Lisiati Fennau. Manon Antoinette Elizabeth Fleming. Joshua James Ferguson Foreman. Jessica Mary French. Kathleen Rose Godba. Brittany Jade Graham. Rodney Allen Jackson. Matthew David Jackham. Adam Arthur Kemp. Vanessa Angela Akata Langi. Melissa Jane Lee. Connor Jewel Gerardus Landers. Eva Lily McCauley. Nadine Skye McKinnon. Joshua Henry Drummond Macy. Stephen John Money. Thomas Henry Gifford Moore. Senior Scholar, Education, Justine O'Dwyer. Sajil Prakash Premar. Annalise Marie Renton. Elizabeth Rosabel Francis Samuel. Olivia Grace Shepherd Sanders. Anthony Kevin Xavier Shishka. Polonga Junior Tuafafo. Hannah Jean Winter. Olivia Clea Young. Postgraduate Diploma in Counselling Theory with Distinction. Stephen Alex Brown. Melanie Lindrum. Barbara Ruth Mackay. Marnie Jane Houlton Sutherland. Postgraduate Diploma in Counselling Theory with Merit, Jane Susan Sewell. Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership with Distinction, Jennifer Jane Triggs. Michael David Wilkinson. Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership with Merit, Deborah Fife Ellery. Jui Hu Liu. Marlene Vandermeer. Postgraduate Diploma in Educational Leadership, Pramesh Chand. To the degree of Master of Counselling with First Class Honours, Nisarg Anna Day. Paula Jane Yateman. To the degree of Master of Counselling, Paul Donald Campbell. To the degree of Master of Educational Leadership with First Class Honours, Jocelyn Patricia Hare. Tamara Catherine Jones. David Edward Gordon Taylor. To the degree of Master of Educational Leadership with Second Class Honours, First Division, Craig Jeffrey Holt. David Wilcock. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with First Class Honours, Chua Chi Liang in Education. Maria Frances Perot in Education. Demelza Round in Education. Fiona Ula Taloa in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Margaret Elizabeth Badenhorst in Education. Shahrizad Binti Yusuf in Education. To the degree of Master of Professional Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Rebecca Janice Elias in Education. Lillian Scudder in Education. Rashai Moana Tairoa in Education. And in absentia, those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma from the Faculty of Education and Social Work.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Susan Jean Bedford in Education, University Doctoral Scholar. Sue researched what teachers need to know in order to support the multimodal authoring of their students. As a result of her work, a body of content knowledge and corresponding model of instruction are proposed in order to broaden understandings of the fundamentals of teaching and learning in this domain. Sue. Joanna Ting Wai Chu in Education, University Doctoral Scholar. Joanna investigated the efficacy and social validity of a group parenting program designed specifically for parents of adolescents to justify the need for a public health approach to supporting such a demographic. Joanna. Matthew Gordon Ray Courtney in Education, University Doctoral Scholar. Matthew developed a statistical model to predict international university student retention based on processes of pastoral care and student interactional strategies on social media. Gail Elizabeth Ayers in Education, University Doctoral Scholar. Gail investigated influences that helped or hindered pre-service teachers' assessment education and identified ways these influences fostered adaptive expertise in using assessment to improve teaching and learning. Murray Olson Gadd in Education. Murray investigated what effective teachers do in the classroom to raise writing achievement levels amongst upper primary age students. His study was designed to help all teachers make a difference for their students as developing writers. Hyen Kim in Education. Hyen investigated 1.5 generation Korean Kiwis' experiences as parents and the influences on their parenting. Her study demonstrated how complex and unique socio-cultural environments have a profound effect on their parenting practices and how these environments can enhance or limit the effectiveness of parenting. Simon John McNamara in Art History. Simon posited through a hermeneutic analysis of Rembrandt's early Passion series that a devotional meditation sequence found in the work of metaphysical poets was a unifying concept in the five paintings of the series. Stephen Michael McTaggart in Sociology. Stephen examined the statistical differences between heterosexual partnerships within marriage and cohabitation from 1981 to 2006. His results show that gender differences remain within both partnership types, reflecting heteronormative cultural values and the impact of motherhood on women's employment and earnings. Stephen. Paula Ray in Media, Film and Television. Paula observed the use of social networking sites by women for political purposes to investigate whether this form of cyber activism can have social impact. She focused on urban Indian women users of Facebook for her case study and discovered a highly active political landscape. Emma Louise Reynolds in French, University Doctoral Scholar, Bright Future Top Achiever Doctoral Scholar. Emma used literary cartography to explore interactions between oral and written traditions of the Kanaki people of New Caledonia, demonstrating how Kanak oral traditions can influence identity construction processes as these islands move towards greater autonomy and potentially independence from France. Emma. Mark William Stewart in Media, Film and Television. Mark examined the shifting state of television since the mid-1990s, looking at how different forms of television programs were made, how they were watched and engaged with, and how they were funded. He used case studies of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Lost, American Idol and Survivor. Mark. Jenny Stumer in Media, Film and Television. Jenny investigated the function of political walls in securing a narrative of separation between peoples. She also examined these walls as forms of media screens whose political and psychological effectiveness can be challenged by the means of art and film. Anthony Hugh Sermon in Theology, University Doctoral Scholar. Anthony investigated continuity and change in the purpose and place of ordained ministers in selected parts of the Anglican Church from the 17th century through to the present. The study was conducted with a view to providing candidates for ordained ministry with a resource to understand the tradition in which they stand. Falaniko Tomaniko in Pacific Studies, University Doctoral Scholar. Falaniko studied what roles present-day Polynesian paramount chiefs play in their respective society. The work looked into the lives of the traditional paramount chiefs of Samoa, Tonga, Fiji, Cook Islands and Aotearoa New Zealand, and how these individuals balance their lives as traditional leaders and as political leaders in positions such as heads of state, presidents and prime ministers. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a doctoral degree in the Faculty of Arts and the Faculty of Education and Social Work.
We are now nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. while you are standing, this would be a great opportunity for you, the graduates, to show your appreciation of your families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped you as you achieved your qualifications. This concludes this meeting of council and convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you all to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your program.